All right. Good morning, you guys. Thank you so much for the weather. We are here at Playhouse Square. The fourth annual Borderline Theater Festival starts today. Awesome. 300 different artists from around, literally around the world, because we have four different countries, right, Jesse? From around the world, converging right here in Cleveland. A tremendous amount of theater performances. And the emphasis is, Josie, correct me if I'm wrong, you try to find acts that we wouldn't typically see throughout the year in Cleveland, right?
Absolutely. Like, you wouldn't see it at a Playhouse Square necessarily. These are independent artists that are coming from all over doing things that might be a little bit weird, a little bit alternative, things that may not be entirely done, but you're watching the process unfold as they perform for you.
That's really cool. And these shows are like a little mini shows. They're not, you know, they're not 4 hours long. Some might be 15 to 20, some might be an hour and a half.
Yeah.
So it just depends. And then there's also free performances going on as well. Is that right?
Absolutely. Some of the performances are actually as short as 10 minutes.
So wow.
You can just pop in and pop out if you want.
Okay. And when we talk about the variety of alternative acts, what are we talking about? People will see a range from of what to what.
So we have a couple of shows. Like, there's a show called Legland. It's a puppetry show, but they tell the story with their legs.
Okay.
There's a show called Shadow that happens in mostly darkness, except for some lighting. And so they have these things called pie lights. So if you're a little nerdy and you know what that means, will be a part of that show.
Okay.
So we can see all types of things. The runaround, is about an Amish misfit. So there's all types of stuff that you can see.
What's really cool is over the years, the show has grown. You guys had the largest number of artists wanting to be a part of the show, submitting applications this year, didn't you?
Yeah, we absolutely did. The festival gets bigger every year. This is the largest amount of artists that we've had come to the festival, so we're really excited.
Why is that important for a festival of this type to grow so much? Because you're really covering also a lot of cultural experiences as well.
Yes, and I don't think that people understand that it takes a lot to do theater, and as an independent artist, sometimes it can be really prohibitive to do your own work.
Mm-hmm.
Having access to places like Playhouse Square sometimes is not in the budget.
Right.
And so, and then a lot of people know or don't know that it takes a lot of time to develop your work, and so having the opportunity to come and develop your work and then potentially tour your work around the country and then also around the world is an amazing opportunity.
Yeah, because we just had that troupe today. They all met at a theater school in Paris, and then they hung out in Vermont and put their troupe together, and now they're performing, you know, this amazing act. And they went to Paris to study physical theater, and now they're going to be performing here.
Yeah.
So cool. All right, so everything starts today. It goes through?
It goes through Saturday.
All right, and how do people get tickets or just find all the information on which performances are going to be where?
So you're going to go to Borderlight, CLE.org, Borderlight, B-O-R-D-E.
Dun, dun, dun.
to see everything. Our website has filters, so if you are just like, I just want to go see international shows or I just want to go see workshops, you can click through the filters and they will guide you to where you need to be.
Awesome. Josie, thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank
it's going
you.
To be an amazing festival this year, guys. I mean, we gave you a variety of stuff. So cool. You should definitely check it out. All right, we're going to go back to you guys in the studio.